Some viewers may find this disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hi, my wonderful sweet babies. It's Destin Choice. And for today's video, I feel like I really had to get on here and talk about the surrounding controversy involving Kim Kardashian getting dragged by the public and getting dragged by the singer, songwriter, and actress, Jude Morris.
So, quick history lesson. For a lot of y'all who are going to be like, who? Who that? So, Jude Morris is basically the woman from the show Star. I'm pretty sure most of y'all watch Star. It was an old Fox show that got canceled, unfortunately, at the expense of Empire. And long story short, Jude Morris is also a singer, songwriter, but she's mostly known for her role as Star in the TV show Star. And she had a lot to get off her chest recently on Instagram.
It's been lingering on me for a second, and I didn't want to make this video at first, but I feel like we have to have a very serious conversation. Kim Kardashian's daughter, Northwest, has been making waves all over the internet because of her infamous TikTok account. Now, Kim Kardashian's 9-year-old daughter, Northwest, has a very popular TikTok account. And North oftentimes will post videos of herself doing her makeup, doing her hair, dancing to nostalgic music, listening to her father's music, and much more. And a lot of times, Kim says that she has and she does supervise her daughter's TikTok account. However, a lot of controversy has been raised recently because Northwest posted a TikTok of her mouthing the lyrics to Ice Spice's new song, The Boy's a Liar. Now, I'm sure most of y'all know who Ice Spice is. Ice Spice is basically the new It Girl. She's a new mainstream female rapper. She's huge right now. She's everywhere. Her song Munch blew up, her song In Her Mood, and her new song The Boy's a Liar is huge all over TikTok. I can't go anywhere without hearing that damn song. It's, at this point, getting annoying. It was cute at first, but now it's getting on my damn nerves. But that song is a really big deal right now, and Ice Spice is just this new solidified star that everybody is talking about right now. So, Northwest, Kim Kardashian, and Kanye's daughter is a big fan of Ice Spice for some odd reason. And lord and behold, Kim Kardashian managed to actually connect the two. Kim Kardashian invited Ice Spice to their home. Ice Spice was making TikToks with Northwest and much more. Now, this was initially very cute and a big surprise to a lot of people. Now, we all know Ice Spice does not make music for kids. Ice Spice makes music for hoes, and Ice Spice makes music for women who like to shake their asses and people who enjoy sexual drill music. That's the kind of music that Ice Spice make.
But people just wasn't paying attention to that, but that's why I'm here. I got that wedding, I'm keeping it clean. Fucking with niggas that's toting a beam. Say that you love me, but what do you mean?
And I can't sit up here and say that kids shouldn't listen to stuff like that, because let's be honest, when you was 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 years old, some of y'all was still listening to Juvenile Back That Ass Up. Some of y'all was still listening to Lil' Kim say, make a Sprite can disappear in her mouth. Some of y'all were still listening to 50 Cent say, I got the magic stick.
You know, most of us were too young to be listening to Chief Keef, but a lot of us were blasting Chief Keef to the rooftop. A lot of all these other drill artists like T.I. when he first came up, Snoop Dogg, and let's not forget that a lot of y'all were way too young to be singing Crime Mob, Rock Your Hips. Now I got 32 flavors of that bootylicious bubblegum, raspberry, grape, cherry, come and get the sunny bun. Like, ew, like, do y'all hear them lyrics? Like, can you believe some of us was like 12, 13, 14, like, rapping and singing along to this? And let's not forget how sexual Aaliyah's Rock the Boat song actually is if you actually listen to it.
And let's not forget that when that song, Broke It Down, first came out, that shit was everywhere, and people were out here dancing to it, and some of us were children listening to this song, repeating these lyrics, and a lot of young girls were dancing to this song back in the day. Like, a lot of y'all were probably too young when this song first came out.
And again, I'm not saying it's okay, because I know a lot of y'all in my comments are going to be like, oh, but that doesn't make it okay, that doesn't make it okay. Shut up. I know. Shut up. I never said it was okay. The point I'm trying to make is, kids are going to listen to what the hell they listen to, even if you are a parent that does supervise your child's things. However, the issue that we have here is that with social media and TikTok taking over, there's just certain things that should not be posting on the internet. And Northwest posting that TikTok was a good example.
Of course, the usual conversation, should children be on social media, raised hell and came up out of nowhere per usual. Now, this is where Jude Morris comes in. She decides to go to her Instagram and she posted this interesting sentiment on her Instagram saying, Jude Morris posted this on her Instagram in the midst of Kanye, Kim Kardashian, and Northwest and Ice Spice all going viral for, you know, that TikTok that was posted. And she put up this sentiment that said, get your children off TikTok. You literally have one job. And then she followed it with an intense caption reading this. Jude Morris said this in her caption.
This is annoying, so I'll delete it later, but it has to be said. The wild part to me is that this even has to be said. A lot of people are upsetting me in the comments because they apparently allow their kids to have social media. They want explanation from me, which is wild to me because, once again, I cannot believe this has to be said. Number one, suicide rates among children, teens, and young adults have risen up 300% since social media was introduced. Science has proven that young people who have social media are 3 times as likely to suffer from depression and self-harm. Saying you monitor them and only allow them to use it for fun doesn't protect them. I'm not talking about just seeing bad stuff. Even using these apps for fun leads to severe anxiety and dopamine withdrawal. TikTok is dangerous and it's not for children. There are no actual fail-proof controls on IG or TikTok. Your kids can see any and everything someone posts, and this is a spectrum of bad content, from pornography to someone discussing ideas you don't agree with. Even if your children slash teens seeing and comparing themselves to others on the line is scientifically bad for them, all of it is a risk to their mental health. Number three, there are millions, and I mean millions, of mostly male predators online for the singular purpose of stalking children. Number four, even us, to be honest, cannot handle this amount of information. Seeing a sick kid, then a funny meme, then a global disaster, then laughing at a comedian, then cooking video, then a video of someone who's grieving is psychotic, and it's damaging our brains. Now, she got a lot of flack from this, and people automatically assumed that she was talking about the whole Kim Kardashian, Northwest, and Ice Spice drama, because granted, this was going viral around the time she literally posted this on her Instagram, and she's not one of those celebrities that talks about controversial issues, hence why she says she was going to delete it afterwards.
And I get what she's saying. She has every right to feel the way she feels, because you gotta remember, there was a life and an era before social media. So when social media came around, there was a lot of situations where a lot of young girls were getting kidnapped. Like, there's young girls that got missing because they were on MySpace posting certain images and talking to certain weirdos. I don't think there's anything wrong with a child being on social media. I just think that there's certain things that they just shouldn't post. And that was just one of those things that just shouldn't have been posted.
But the issue at hand is, she does have a point. And I do feel as though that TikTok should not be something that kids should be on. I do find it cringe that whenever I go places like to a grocery store, if I go here or go there, or if I, you know, sit inside of a train, I see parents allowing their kids to just scroll through TikTok, and then the parents are probably 9 times out of 10 doing the same thing. 9 times out of 10, they don't even know what their kid is watching. Their kid is just watching, absorbing information, soaking this stuff in, and you have no idea what they're being brainwashed, hypnotized into saying, the kind of things that they're being told to repeat. I feel as though that North at 9 years old really should not be on TikTok posting content like this, because again, there are predators out there.
Kim Kardashian never addressed the backlash. However, she did remove the TikTok after it went viral, and she got a lot of controversy for letting her daughter mouth certain lyrics and shift her hips a certain way.
Kim Kardashian has made it very clear that her daughter doesn't absorb any information. Her daughter is fine. Her daughter is perfect, because in Kim Kardashian's head, she wants everyone to see her as perfect and as perfect as possible, because, you know, Kim Kardashian is very egocentric because she's been the center of attention for a long time.
And let's also not forget that Kanye West said the same thing. So if you guys didn't know, last year, Northwest was going ham with her TikToks, posting all types of makeup looks, which was fine. You know, it's fine for her to be expressing herself through makeup and all that other shit that kids like to do. But Kanye West had issue with her doing a lot of emo-related content, because Kanye saw a lot of that stuff as low energy. And when he did address Kim Kardashian about it, she had an attitude and she refused to make North take the TikToks down. And Kanye West ran the social media blasting the Kardashians for being low energy, not the best role models. And he said a lot more literally last year. And this has literally resurfaced.
Hey, everybody. I just got off the phone with Kim. I told her to stop antagonizing me with this TikTok thing. I said it's never again. I am her father. I know y'all don't respect fathers and the idea of family, and media tries to promote something. I said, I am not allowing my daughter to be used by TikTok, to be used by Disney. I have a say-so. And then when people say, oh, they're going to use this for you in court, I didn't have a say-so on whether or not they went to Sierra Canyon. Most men do not. There's no such thing as 50-50 custody with in society today. That's not even, it always leans towards the mom.
Along with Kanye's rant, Kanye also screenshotted Northwest TikTok, and he captioned a photo of Northwest on his Instagram by saying, "Since this is my first divorce, I need to know what I should do about my daughter being put on TikTok against my will." Basically implying that Kim won't take all the TikToks down. But overall, Kanye West went in on this video, making it very clear last year that he does not want his daughter on TikTok. Kim did notably respond, and she said this. And her basic ideology was this: "I want to let my daughter express herself the best way she knows how, so basically fuck you." Kim Kardashian has said throughout time and numerous times that North does not have access to the outside world. She said that North's phone is very censored, it's child blocked. On top of it being censored and child blocked, she also made sure that she's the only person that has TikTok on her phone and that North can't get on TikTok unless she's using her phone.
Like, I mean, my kids, they don't know anything.
How?
So,
with social, they're in school, they're North, on social.
So at school, like, some of my best friends are the teachers, so I know what goes on at recess. I know what goes on at lunchtime. I hear what's being talked about. None of the kids have ever said anything to my kids.
Wow.
Social media, my kids aren't. North has a TikTok account on my phone and my phone only. They're just not on social media. They don't see stuff. I keep, you know, when stuff's going down, like, I protect stuff in the house as far as like the TVs and the content that's on.
That feels
like
it must be a full-time job.
It is.
Yeah.
It is.
And see, this is an example of dishonest parenting. And this is the issue that I have with some parents who sit up here and say, "Well, my kid doesn't know anything." They don't. Bitch, how the fuck she know who Ice Spice is? Let alone trying to dance like her and arching her back and, like, you know, taking a little back shot. Like Ice Spice, like, how the hell she know who Ice Spice is, but yet you protect her and censor everything she does? I mean, let's be honest for a second. Your daughter is 9 years old. How the hell does she know what an Ice Spice is? Ice Spice isn't on Disney Channel. Ice Spice isn't, she's not on Peppa Pig or whatever the hell kids listen to. Like, she's a sexualized image. Like, she, you know, does what she does because it pays the bills, and she obviously makes music for grown-ass women who like to dance to her music, but she's like the Jezebel spirit. She's a sexualized image. I don't understand how she can sit up here and say that she monitors everything and says that her kids are oblivious and stuff. How does she sit up here and say with a straight face that her kid, that she knows everything that goes on at lunch, she knows everything that goes on at recess? Let's be honest, when we were children, the minute the teachers walked away, we were talking about crazy ass shit. We were talking about seeing dead bodies. We were talking about guns. We were talking about, like, who's the biggest thought in, you know, in first period. Or, oh, well, you know, she dated like 9 different boys, so she's a thought. Or, oh, so-and-so, Javante had sex for the first time and he's only 11. Like, this is the kind of shit we were talking about when adults weren't looking. So it's very dishonest and disingenuous of her to sit up here and say that her children are oblivious to everything. But yet, in the same breath, you invite Ice Spice in your home to make TikToks with your daughter.
You know, when social media first came out back in, like, 2003, there was a time where every single time you turned on your TV late at night, you heard a horror story about a young girl getting kidnapped on Hi5, or a young girl getting kidnapped and abducted in human traffic from these dudes that she met off of MySpace, or young women meeting their crush off of MySpace and then getting catfished. Like, 2005 was the era where everybody and their fucking mom got catfished for like 5-10 years. So that's the thing about social media and the dangers of it, is that predators are out there and people will prey on your ignorance and your vulnerability. And imagine being a child who your parent thinks they're supervising you, but they're really not. And that's why I feel like sometimes the parents are to blame, because you have to teach your child how to protect themselves from the dangers of the world.
Especially when it has to do with the world we live in terms of the internet. No, and I know parents teach their kids the basic shit as far as, like, don't open the door, don't talk to strangers, blah, 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 and all that basic stuff. But we live in a digital era, and a lot of parents did not grow up in that era. So a lot of parents don't realize that some of your kids may be out here with a secret burner phone or a secret burner account. Or they might be at school, and somebody might be showing them shit on their phone. You gotta teach your fucking kids using social media, who are on social media, stay the F away from this. If someone shows you this on their phone, don't look at it. Stay away from it. Don't look at this. Don't engage. This isn't true. That isn't true. And I get it. When kids are young, it's hard to have these kind of conversations. And many people may also say, well, you don't have children, so you don't understand. And you're right. I may not understand. But there's certain things you could easily tell your kids instead of trying to clothe them away from it. You can definitely
hide your kids from the world, but you can't hide the world from your kids forever. They're going to want to go seeking things out and see the real world. When I was a child, my mom's solution to things was just turning off the TV or just saying, you can't watch stuff like that. When I would watch Maury, my dad would be like, nope, turn that shit off. I don't want you guys watching that kind of stuff, period. But in an era where everyone has a smartphone and people like to share things and repost things, there's certain apps that even allow your kids to even hide things. I don't know if y'all heard about that app, but there's an app that a lot of kids have been using that looks like a calculator. So when parents click on it, they think it's a calculator, but they don't realize that in that calculator app, there's literally a whole other world of like messages and secret photos of codes in it that you would never even know about.
It was stupid, yeah.
So how do these cyber secret keepers work?
So this looks like an ordinary calculator app for the iPhone.
Yahoo Tech Magazine editor-in-chief Dan Tynan gave us a demo.
You tap it. It looks like a standard calculator. In fact, it is the standard calculator. But when you enter the secret password that your child created and you hit the percent key, now you have a photo album. Now there's pictures hidden in here that your child didn't want you to see.
Apps like these becoming so popular, a county district attorney in Alabama sent out a warning to parents.
You and I know if one child knows about it, many children know about it. So take a minute, grab that phone.
And some parents we spoke to weren't too happy about it.
Surprise, I'm shocked.
It's very scary to me to think about it.
It would be upsetting to me, especially if the child was younger.
Experts say you can keep your kids from these apps by turning off their ability to install apps without your approval.
You should teach your child right from wrong. But how can Northwest know what's right and what's wrong when she sees her mother and her aunts and her cousins doing certain things on the internet? Having childish views, childish-ass debates, going in on people, doing publicity stunts. How can she ignore stuff like that? You know, she may think that her daughter's oblivious to it, but that's in her own little la-la land. Children see everything. When you were 8, 9, and 10, and your parents were arguing and fighting about the things that were insane, you were absorbing these things. You knew these things, you know? And then when you bring these things up to your parents years later, they're shocked that you even knew about that. Kids know things. They just don't say anything. Kids know things in terms of, like, sexuality, what this is, what that is, because growing up, a lot of us were watching Family Guy, South Park. A lot of us were watching inappropriate TV shows back then, like BET Uncut. BET Uncut was a wild time. As a child, I remember waiting for my parents to go to sleep. I would turn on BET or turn on Adult Swim, and I would watch some crazy ass shit as a kid, because I was just like, damn, okay, they won't let me let the TV on. They think they can monitor me. Okay, I'm gonna wait when they're not looking to do some shit. So instead of my parents telling me this is wrong, you shouldn't watch this because of this kind of energy, I was like, I don't know why they don't want me to watch it, because they wouldn't explain, because my parents very much had a, well, I don't give a fuck what you think. I'm not gonna explain to you why this isn't wrong. Just don't do it. And that caused me to go seek things out on my own. So instead of trying to shield me, they should have probably enlightened me and educated me on why low energy things like that should not be consumed at people at my age when I was younger. You know, back then they could have just shut off the TV or added a little child block. But listen, I didn't give a damn. I was still finding a way. BET Uncut was that fucking show back then.
I ain't got no pants on the dance floor.
A lot of us were watching salacious content back then, where back in the day there were chat rooms where people would say disgusting and racist things. And then there's other badass kids at school that bring salacious naked images, or they go on their phones and they show you things. All in all, Kim Kardashian should have done a better job supervising her child's social media, because if you were really supervising her social media, you would have saw that shit and you would have immediately said, no, this is inappropriate. Why are you mouthing these lyrics? It's one thing for her to be with Ice Spice mouthing the lyrics as fun and games because there's adult supervision there and she's with her favorite celebrity. That's one thing. But for her to be in the private of her own room and to upload that shit. But all in all, everything Jude DeMora said was absolutely true. Kim Kardashian deserved the backlash, and everything Kanye said was absolutely true. Kanye West got a lot of flack from Kim Kardashian because she went off on him and dragged him and said that he needs to just mind his business and just let their daughter express herself. And I feel as though that if Kanye was in the household, it probably wouldn't have happened. But maybe North is taking the divorce very hard, because that's usually what happens when you grow up with your parents being together, and then when they suddenly break up when you're really young, you don't know how to mentally handle it or process it, it starts to irritate you. So you start trying to, you know, reevaluate life. And part of reevaluating life as you step into puberty is trying to find yourself. And maybe she's finding herself through creative outlets like TikTok and makeup and hair and dancing, and maybe looking up to a lot of musicians that she sees on the internet who look like her. But overall, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope you guys enjoyed my rant talking about this. Please let me know what you guys thought about this. Please give your thoughts and opinions. Email me what you guys want me to talk about next. Please be sure to DM me on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram. And join my Patreon. It's as low as $2 if you guys are interested. And yeah, that's that. Choice out this bitch.
Why don't we fall in love? It's so many reasons. It's the only thing that matters to me. It's so many reasons. It takes such a load off to let you know that you're the only one I will ever want to go. Think I never did know what to do. A love I never felt, now I feel for you. Why don't I just swallow each and every ounce of my pride? Everything you do, I wanna feel again. Ain't no use for us to pretend. Cause why can't we fall in love?
That's all you get for free. Thanks for watching, y'all. Follow me on Instagram. Enjoy my Patreon.